Hit it. Yeah. Stay a little bit behind you.
You know, experience is almost shocking. It's something that's surreal that cars will just let you run into the thing right in front of you. They should be able to detect the object, the person, whatever it is that's crossing your path. And the reality is humans are not perfect. You know, these things happen all the time in very unfortunate circumstances and accidents. I think it's the responsibility of the automaker, of these technology providers, to be able to actually change that, to be able to make a difference, and to be able to solve that last 1%.
What we observe these days in the industry is that companies mostly focus on developing robotaxis that would operate without a driver in a level 4, level 5 fashion. Active safety features have taken a backseat. We don't believe that this is the right approach. We believe that there's a lot of undiscovered value in providing extremely safe, almost uncrashable vehicles. Proactive safety for us is really all about preventing accidents. Today's systems, and you see this as an example over here, today's systems really focus on mitigating collisions. They maybe detect them in time, they usually detect it way too late, and then they do something to mitigate the impact, the severity of the crash. Obviously, that's not enough. You need to make sure that whatever you build gets to and stopped in time. And the baseline for it is really preventing collisions here on this test track in those very simple situations. If you can't solve this, it's pretty much impossible to solve autonomy on a big scale, especially in urban environments. The automotive industry has a standard test catalog by which active safety features are being evaluated. It's called NCAP. NCAP is an organization that defines those tests and sets the bar. The bar is set very, very low at this point in time. Right? The test cases, the scenarios that are set up are easy to solve scenarios. They are focused towards legacy sensors like radars and cameras. We wanted to see, compare how well do we do versus one of the most respected brands in the ADAS AD world. Seen today a very consistent behavior, but unfortunately the wrong type of consistent behavior. The car basically did not brake at all. On the other hand side, we also saw our Hydra-powered proactive safety system. The car was approaching the objects with a velocity of 50 or 60 kph and in every case broke for it in time to come to a safe stop and not hit the pedestrian.
I'm actually old enough to remember a time where seatbelts in Germany were not mandatory. Some of the cars didn't even have them. So I remember that phase, and it was a pretty long phase where people actually were hesitant of putting that thing on. There were newspaper articles, is that really safe, is it not safe?
I've been driving 15 years. I've never had an accident or a moving violation. Besides, it messes up the clothes.
We went through this phase and it was very clear that seat belts were the thing to have and they would really make you safe in a crash. The discussion that we're currently seeing with companies saying you can do level 4 with radar only, you can do level 4 with camera only, you can do level 4 with lidar, is exactly that kind of discussion. I see a couple of really similar traits to that. And I think what's going to come out of it is you really want the best solution that will enable to give you the best road safety. And we believe that that's LiDAR and Luminar LiDAR, to be specific. Over the last decade or so, there has been a lot of work in bringing driver assistance from something that will purely assist the driver towards really autonomous driving. What that gives us as a technology puzzle piece is a massively powerful safety and accident prevention stack.